Welcome to VoiceAIWrapper. This tutorial will cover the basic navigation inside the app. And once you go into these specific features, there will be videos that will explain the feature in detail. So once you're done signing up for our free trial and done with your onboarding questions, you will land up on a screen like this. The first step will be to connect a voice API provider. And I'm using the example of retail here. So you can add your org name, your retail API key, and hit connect. Once you're done with that, you'll see a card like this appear here. Inside VoiceAIWrapper, you have two sets of controls. So on the left-hand side, these are your account level controls for VoiceAIWrapper. And when you add different voice API providers, each API provider then has its own set of controls. So for example, when I added retail here, if I click on dashboard, now it takes me inside my retail configuration. So I can see all my retail agents, my retail phone numbers, and so on. Back to our account settings. So on the left-hand side, you have an option to add your custom domain and agency branding. There's an option to connect your Stripe keys. Adding your Stripe key will allow you to create custom plans. You can mark up voice minute pricing. You can charge subscription fee. There's a variety of billing options that we offer for agencies. And we'll go into detail when you look at the agency product video. Client orgs allows you to create different client sub-accounts. You can create users, give them access to specific assets, and control pretty much what your client portal looks like. SaaS Creator is an automated process of onboarding clients. So while you can add clients one by one using the client org feature, SaaS Creator allows you to embed a code on your website and automate the client payment and onboarding process. We'll have a detailed video on how SaaS Creator works. Under settings, you have an option to add your own API key. This works when you this works with a callback feature that we offer. Pretty unique to VoiceAIWrapper. For help, you have a chat bubble here, and then you'll see a help section here. If you click onto it, you'll see guided walkthroughs, and there's an option to book a call with us. If you use Slack, feel free to let us know on the chat, and we'll invite you to our private Slack channel for support. That's it. We'll meet again when you go into product-specific videos. Adding your own domain and your brand assets is pretty straightforward. So for that, head over to White Label and then add your subdomain. And when you add it for the first time, you then see DNS entries populate here. You take them, add it to your DNS provider. Once you're done connecting your subdomain, you will then see an option to validate. It takes a couple of minutes depending on the DNS providers, but once you click validate, you'll see a success message here, which means your domain is now connected with the app. And when your clients log in, they can go to your subdomain and they'll see their app, which is your version of the app under your own brand. Under branding, you can upload logos, meta title, a description for your clients to see when they log into your app. You need to have a domain connected before you add branding assets to save the configuration. VoiceAIWrapper gives you the option to build clients offline as well as online. When you want to build your clients offline, we currently support Stripe. All you need to do is connect, go to your Stripe account and connect your Stripe keys here. Connecting your Stripe key allows you to create products inside VoiceAIWrapper, and these products are automatically created in your Stripe account, and then when your clients make payments, the money goes directly to your bank account. After you've connected your Stripe account, you can create products to resell to your clients. Now, since your Stripe is connected, when you create a product inside VoiceAIWrapper, it automatically gets created inside your Stripe account. So to create a product to resell to your clients, go here, and then after you fill in the product description, you can choose different mailing methods. So you can bill your clients based on usage, and you can decide how frequently you want to bill them. So let's say your provider is charging you 10 cents per minute, you can decide to charge your clients 20 cents per minute. Then you have a subscription plus overage billing method, which means you can charge your clients a subscription fee. And let's say you're including 10 minutes in that subscription, and beyond those 10 minutes, if they use more voice minutes, then you want to charge them 30 cents per minute, right? This all gets billed automatically because your Stripe is connected, and you can track that in your Stripe dashboard. There's another plan type, which is subscription plus usage pack. Again, this gives you the flexibility to charge the client a fixed subscription fee based on a billing frequency that you decide. And for voice minutes, you can then create a usage pack. A voice minute usage pack basically allows you to define the number of minutes for a certain cost. This is really useful when clients have varying volumes of usage, month to month or week to week, and they don't want to get into a specific plan, but they want to buy minutes in bulk at will. So after you've created your products, none of these products are going to get activated in a client account automatically, right? For that, you would need to associate the product inside the client org. If you head over to client org, you'll see a video which will explain how to associate your product with a particular client organization. All right, this is the place where you create sub accounts or client accounts, and then you can add access for them. You would create a client org after you have added your domain to the white label settings. So to create a client org, I'll enter the client name. So let's say my new client, and then this email ID is going to create a customer in your Stripe account automatically, right? So this is important from a billing perspective. So once you have connected your Stripe key and you enter an email ID here, this will create a customer in your Stripe account. So when your client makes a payment, Stripe knows which customer account to associate the payment with. Once you've added your client org, you get an option to create users. This is the username and password that your client users would use to access your white label platform. Under asset groups, you can decide which agent and what voice provider you want to use for this client. We allow you to add multiple voice providers, so you can pick and choose which one you want to use for this client. So for example, I have a asset group name for Pipe Piper, and I can decide which campaign I want to associate to this particular account, which agent I want to associate, and there's a long list of choices down here. You can also control what level of access clients have to the assets you've allocated, right? So let's say you have associated an agent to the client account, but you don't want them to edit the agent or see the agent or run a test call. You can control them using these toggles. The last stop is billing. So in the previous video, if you head over to agency products, there's a video which explains how you can create products to sell to your clients. And your entire product catalog is going to show up here, along with the usage packs that you have created. And then this is where you can decide which plan to assign to this client, right? As long as if you have not assigned a specific plan to the client will not get a prompt to make a payment. So if you want a specific plan to be assigned to a specific client, you can just click on assign option here. And when the client logs in, they'll see the Stripe paywall, which is your Stripe paywall with your brand name, and they'll be able to access your white label version of the account after making a payment for the plan that you've assigned to them. That's it. All right, so SaaS Creator is an automated method of onboarding clients and billing them. What you see above is a manual method of adding client accounts, assigning passwords, while SaaS Creator makes it fully automated. SaaS Creator is available on certain product pricing tiers for VoiceAIWrapper. So how this works is after you connect to your Stripe account, you've created agency products here, you can then create a pricing table. Inside this pricing table, you have a lot of control of, you know, how frequently do you want to bill. So it's almost like having a pricing table on a SaaS website, and then you can add the products that you have onto your pricing table. So I've already created one, and this is an example of how it's going to look like after you add your product. So all the text that you see here, including your CTA text, all of this can be customized, and you can go in here and, you know, change a lot of stuff, the text, the design, and the layout. Once you're done with this, you can either take this code, directly paste it on your website. That way, when people come to your website and let's say they click on get started, it'll automatically create a customer account. It'll automatically give them the plan that you have associated with this tier, and it'll automate the entire onboarding process, client onboarding process. Usually I've seen agencies set up a Slack notification whenever somebody makes a payment, because both Stripe as well as VoiceAIWrapper sends you a notification that someone, a new client, has signed up, and then you can set up an onboarding call to onboard your new client. If you have a certain theme or CSS schema on your website and you don't want to take this embed code, then you can simply right click and take the URL behind this button, as long as you don't change the URL. Of course, that entire URL is white labeled. It doesn't have VoiceAIWrapper, Vapi, Retail, or any VoiceAI provider anywhere. As long as you don't change that, that URL is also serve the same purpose and onboard your entire client onboarding and payment process. Okay, so in this video, we'll explain to you how the campaign functionality works inside VoiceAIWrapper. So we give you the option to create in both inbound and outbound campaigns, and there are some advanced functionalities associated with our campaign workflow. So I'll take an example of an outbound campaign. Before you create an outbound campaign, when you connect your VoiceAI provider for the first time, make sure you sync the webhook URL. This makes sure that your agents can now be used with the campaign functionality in us. It doesn't change anything on the agent side, but it syncs the agent inside VoiceAIWrapper and makes it ready to be used inside campaigns. Same thing applies for your phone number. If it's not synced, you will not see it available inside campaigns. So I'll head back into campaigns. Let's take the example of an outbound campaign. The first thing is the ability to add leads via API. So we have three APIs. We have an add lead API, which means you can feed leads into your voice campaign from a GHL, Airtable, anywhere. Similarly, you have a remove lead API, which can dynamically remove leads from the campaign so that you don't end up calling them. And we have a do not call API, right? So these are applicable for different use cases, but you can automate the lead add and remove and management process through our API. Then of course you can add leads via bulk upload, or you can add leads manually. Under settings, you can select your agent, select your phone number. We also have a functionality called pool numbers, where you can have like hundreds of numbers, and you can select a number pool, and our system will automatically distribute the calls across those numbers in a round robin fashion. More about that in a later video. So under campaign settings, you have granular controls, start date, end date, start time, end time, days of the week you're gonna call, total number of dial attempts per day, the maximum number of dial attempts per day, the gap between each dial attempt, and then how are you handling answers, right? Are you considering voicemail as answer, or are you skipping them as not answer? Couple of important features here. Let's say you are a GHL user. You can create an inbound webhook inside GHL and just paste it here. This will send all your campaign call logs into GHL without you having to maintain any other third-party automation. There's another functionality which can be enabled in our campaign settings, which is callback settings. This allows the agent to call back. So let's say the agent is calling a contact and the contact says, call me back in 5 minutes. This functionality sends that information to the agent, and the agent can call back that contact in 5 minutes in respect to the time zone that the contact is in. Okay. There's a detailed explanation on how this works. For this, you need to add your OpenAI key into your VoiceAIWrapper account. All calls are available here. There's a filter here, so you can filter call logs. So the same thing is available on the client side, and you have controls over what fields you want to show and what you want to hide. If you have certain custom fields, that will also show up here. If there are certain fields that you want us to add, we're happy to do so. Lastly, you have campaign level analytics for every campaign. You also have cost metrics, which again can be hidden in case you don't want to show to the client. This is the admin side, so you see your cost and the bill cost, but for the client side, you can control what they get to see. Similarly, you can create inbound campaigns. The difference with inbound campaigns is when people, unknown people call you, you can see their first name as long as you're enabling structured data and you are asking for their name in the agent prompt. You can see a list of people who have been calling you and all their details and their call logs. Just like you do it in Vapi, retail, or anywhere else, you will be able to see the call transcript, the call recording, the summary, and all of that. And you will also be able to send that to a third-party system using our webhook API if required. And of course, you do have an option to download your call logs from inside the app.